guys, Andrew Wasson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Today, I'm going to explain a strategy that will teach you how to get rid of that experience of not knowing where to begin when it comes to playing a guitar solo. See, the trick here is to learn how to understand what causes the problems of not knowing what scales to use, what area of the neck to start playing from, and what type of lead-in, or what we'll call the starting notes, which would be the best notes for jumping into the guitar solo that you want to play. So let's get things started here by learning what scale to use before playing your next guitar solo. The way that you would understand what key that you're in, what the root note is of the key, and whether the idea that you're playing over is major or minor is by way of something called a 5-1 resolution. Now we're going to take a look at a major idea like this at first, and the chord progression starts on a C major chord, and at the very end of the progression we're going to a G, and then that takes us in a repeat back to the very beginning again. Now that's called a 5-1 resolution. The one being the C major chord, which means that since we're going from a 5 chord away, G is 5 notes away from C, once we do that movement, we anchor the sound, and it's called using a cadence. So that means that it's a very strong pull back to that home chord once again. And this means also that for us to play a solo on this group of chord changes, we're going to be using the C major scale. Now let me play these changes for you. This sounds like this. Now listen, there's the home chord again. So that 5-1 resolution is really strong, and like I said, 80% of the progressions out there are going to do this type of scenario. And also, I want to cover what it would look like if we were dealing in minor. And what's going to be interesting is we're going to go to an A minor for this, but we're going to keep all the chord changes in the central part of the progression the same. The D minor, the E minor, the F major, they're all the same as they were from our C major progression. And that's because these two progressions are linked by way of an idea called relative harmony. So C major contains all the same notes as A minor, so they're relative to one another. But when we begin the progression from an A minor and we do another 5-1 resolution at the end, which takes us from an E minor in the key of A back to that root chord of A minor, we solidify the sound and the coloring of A minor. Let me play this progression for you now. Hear that resolution from the cadence, the E minor to the A minor. So that's how you do it. You know, this progression here would be in the key of A minor. You'd use A minor scale to solo over it. That first progression we did would be in C major, so you'd use C major scale to solo over it. All right, guys, coming up, I'm going to get into the next big idea that you need to know, which is where on the neck would be the best place to begin playing your guitar solo. But first, I want to tell you about a promotional offer that I'm running for my Handouts Collection ebook. I want to let you know about our Handout Collection ebook, Volume 6. This is my latest collection of study material. There are 76 pages of great information in here, and if you already are one of the thousands of guitar players who've received your copy, you know how great this collection is. Handout Collection Volume 6 is a 76-page digital ebook that you can download and print on demand at home. We'll email you the file within 24 hours of making your donation or a Teespring merchandise purchase. Volume 6 covers the open position and bar chords. There's an arpeggio workout, a harmonized keys workout, exercises on popular triads, a lesson on how to practice scales, and all the popular modes, including Ionian, Aeolian, Dorian, Mixolydian, and Lydian. There's even a section on the diminished scale, and even some jazz theory, along with pretty much every type of guitar notation worksheet paper that exists. The Handout Collection ebook is available with any donation over $5, or if you make a purchase from the Creative Guitar Studio Teespring store. Just visit creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to help support my lessons. Or you can check out all of our Teespring products in the console underneath this video. So once you get clear on the scale that you're going to be using for playing your guitar solo, the next thing that's important to decide on before you start to play is where on the neck that you'll begin performing that all-important first phrase. Let's get into this by reviewing some options for where you could start when it comes to laying down those all-important first notes of the solo. When it comes to where on the neck that you're going to play something, there's kind of two ideas you want to focus on. One is the range of how low or how high something is played. Normally a solo starts higher up because we want those notes to punch through and really attract the listener's attention. And then the other thing is what the perceived sound quality is going to be of a line, you know, kind of comparative tone color of where you're located with a part. And that's going to be a little more complex, but when you hear what I'm going to do to explain this, you'll know right away what I'm talking about. Let's start with the really simple aspect of where in terms of range, you know, low compared to high. So I've got a statement that's just, you know, going on between an A minor and a D minor chord. And this statement goes like this. I'm going to play it low at first. So it's kind of a, you know, fun kind of, you know, pentatonic scale phrase. It's in A minor, but it's kind of low and blurry down there. Here it is up higher on the neck, really punching through now. It just really sings up there because we took it up, you know, basically two octaves higher. Now, to get the clarity of this, of how important it is and what the sound scope is like when you go and play a backing track around it, I have those chord changes of A minor to the D minor and A minor in the background. I have them on the loop pedal. I'm going to fire that up and I'm going to play each location. You're going to get a chance to really hear the difference. So here we go. So that's the low. Can tell up high, it really sings, it jumps right out to the listener, and it's really impactful up there because it's really soaring, you know, and how high that is in relationship. It's two octaves higher, you know, from what I played down here. So those are some of the, you know, aspects you really want to keep in mind when you're starting your solo. You know, try and go higher up the neck. It's going to really create a better impact to your listener. Now, the other aspect I have for you, it's going to compare a unison tones line. So I'm going to put the line in the mid register. Here it is now. So it sounds nice there, but I'm going to play it elsewhere too. I'm going to do it off fifth string. Check it out. You can tell it's kind of getting a little bit blurry down on those thicker guitar strings. Now let's fire up the loop pedal and play each one, and you can determine which one you like better. You can tell that one that's kind of on the lower string sets there from fifth string, it's blurry. That one's much brighter and it really is impactful. Now, the overall tonal color is being affected, but the notes aren't, because these are the same notes exactly. They're unisons of one another. But what changes that tonal color, what gives you that difference in the perceived sound quality, that is having to do with the length and diameter of your guitar strings. You know, they're shorter and thicker when you're playing it off fifth string, but when you go off fourth string, you know, you're getting into longer and some thinner gauge strings, so the impact is greater. It really kind of sings a little bit more. So keep this in mind too, because sometimes people come up with notes in a certain area, but you know, they probably would be better off suited to be in a different location of the deck. You can keep the exact same notes, but the different location will give them a much better perceived sound quality, especially when you're playing over top of a backing track. If you're signed up as one of my Patreon supporters, you'll have a bonus part two video where I'll get into the third most important idea to learn about before you play a solo, which is knowing what note to start on. Along with the bonus video, as a Patreon member, you'll also get a jam track, plus you'll get to download a very detailed PDF handout. And that handout is really detailed. It has everything that we do in the YouTube lesson, including the piece that you heard me play at the very start of the YouTube lesson, and then it goes over everything that we're going to be doing in the Patreon video. So head down to my Patreon page and become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Well, guys, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. The comments are great for leaving your opinions and your ideas about some of the topics that we covered. Maybe you can even help out others with some ideas of your own that helped you over the years with these topics. The thumbs up is for the YouTube algorithms. It just helps me get more views here on YouTube. So please give the video a thumbs up and help me out. Also, remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just, you know, random YouTube videos. That's all available over at my website at creativeguitarstudio.com. There's a complete beginners program, there's a great intermediate course, and there's a really excellent advanced guitar program that you can study from. And on top of all that, there's fantastic electives on the site. You can go and study acoustic guitar, guitar technique, guitar soloing, music reading, ear training. All those courses are super in-depth. There's like 20 to 30 lessons for all of them, and it's just unbelievable the amount of work we've put into them. So go check it out at creativeguitarstudio.com. You're going to really enjoy it. Plus, you're going to want to see all of my guitar lessons that I post here on YouTube. So go and turn on the notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again later this week with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now. When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.